I'm excited to announce three new product updates here at Audible Genius. New add-on lessons for Syntorial, new community forums, and a Syntorial 2.2 update. Let's start with the add-on lessons. Head into your online account and go into the Syntorial download sections for you demo users to click additional downloads. And once in there, you'll see these new add-on lessons where we've started with the first one, New Wave Volume 1. This is a Syntorial lesson in which you recreate patches just like you do in the regular lessons. But these will be patches from famous new wave artists like Devo, The Cars, Blondie, Depeche Mode, Aha. And they're a lot of fun to recreate. Click it to download. Now you'll need the Syntorial 2.2 update we released this week as well, so you can get that here. And for you Windows users, note that if you're already downloading Syntorial, it's a big file. If you click New Wave Volume 1, there may just be a delay in its download start, but it will. Once downloaded, unzip it, go into your newly installed Syntorial 2.2 update, and up in the options menu, you'll see a new open lesson feature. This lets you launch a lesson from file. Select that New Wave Volume 1, start it. There you go. And now you just go back and forth between the visible patch and try to recreate that patch here, just like a regular Syntorial lesson. You'll see the artist and song name for each patch. Now, Syntorial users, owners of the full version of Syntorial will get access to these add-on lessons for free. Demo users can load up to three of them before they'll have to upgrade to the full version. Now, again, New Wave Volume 1 is just the first one that we're doing. We plan to add more, cover more genres, more artists, and we want your feedback. So if you want to have a say in this, head over to our new community forums. We have three new forums. The first one is the Synth Patch Preset Share. Here you can ask for help with specific patches. Tell us the artist, the song, you know, post a YouTube video so we can hear the song, mention what time it starts, and we'll give you some tips, even give you some synth patch recipes to help you figure these out. You'll see there's already a bunch here. This column shows ones where people still need help. These are ones in which instructions have been given, the patch has been recreated. These were all brought over from our old Syntorial.com forum, so there's a lot to work with. And you can upvote the ones you want to see recreated. And we're going to pay attention to all of this as we decide what patches to recreate and what new add-on lessons to offer. Along with that forum, we have a Syntorial forum where you can ask for new features in Syntorial, ask for help in the course, report bugs, talk about synthesis, and a building blocks forum. Again, you can ask for features in building blocks, ask for help in the course, report bugs, and talk about beat composition. And the Syntorial 2.2 update, along with the new add-on lessons, we have added a bunch of convenience features for demonstrations and challenges. Let's launch a lesson. Final challenge. In the demonstration, you can now adjust the volume of the video separate from the challenge synth. You can also change the speed using keyboard shortcuts. Up arrow makes it faster, down arrow slower. And it will save your last speed. So every time you launch a lesson, it will start that video at the last speed you used. This is great if you always like to listen to your videos at faster or slower speeds. You don't have to set it every time. And the Japanese subtitles have been improved and refined in this version. Hop over to the challenge. We've added a few new features here as well, starting with the auto playback toggle. By default, when you go to the next patch, it automatically starts playing it. This is ideal for most of us, but some of you guys like to manually play the synth. You don't like using playback, so this gets kind of annoying. You have to stop it every time. Well, disable that here. And now, when I go to the next patch, it won't play it. Next, we have enhanced our QWERTY keyboard capability. You already can play the synth with your QWERTY keyboard, but now you can also control the pitch wheel, mod wheel, and QWERTY velocity presses. You can move the pitch wheel up with the right square bracket key, and left square bracket key will lower it. Use the plus key to nudge the mod wheel up, and the minus key to nudge it down. And then you can change the velocity of the QWERTY keyboard presses. By default, a QWERTY keyboard press is like medium velocity. It doesn't matter how hard or light you press your keyboard. But if you hit comma, that'll bring the velocity down a little bit. Hit it again, even more. Use the period key to increase the velocity. And lastly, for those of you who missed the version 1 cheering and clapping when you submit a patch, we have brought that back as an option. Go into preferences and enable use V1 audio responses when submitting patches. And now, when you submit a patch, yeah! Ah, nostalgia. Enjoy our updates.